read from God's Word in Genesis chapter 2. We read, "The Lord God said, 'It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him.' So the Lord God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, he took one of man's ribs and closed up the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib he had taken out of man, and he brought her to the man. And the man said, 'This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man.' For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother, and he will cleave to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Join us in prayer. Father, we thank you for this day and for this noble hour to which you've brought us. I ask your special blessings upon this service, everything that we say and do. Make us aware of the eternal significance of marriage. We ask that your Holy Spirit would seal this marriage bond. I pray that Riley and Amanda would be a strength, encouragement to society, but more than that, glory to your name, Father. Impress upon each one here the sacredness of the marriage vows. We thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Marriage was ordained by God as a blessing for man. One of the biblical proverbs says that whoever finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains the favor of the Lord. I'd like to ask you, Cliff, if by walking down the aisle with your daughter, are you and your wife affirming that you're giving your full blessing to this marriage, the marriage of your daughter to this man? Are you also hereby transferring your God-given responsibility for the care and protection of your daughter to this man?
We do.
Good. Y'all come stand here. Marriage was anticipated in creation, for God made us male and female. And he endowed man with a unique capacity for love. And we read in the scripture that as we have Christ's love in us, then we approximate God, for God is love. The marriage union is born out of love, cemented in love, and nourished by love. Cliff is going to now read for us from the New Testament, 1 Corinthians 13, and also from 1 John 4.
Love suffereth long and is kind. Love envieth not. Love vaunteth not itself, is not puffed up, doth not behave itself unseemly, seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil, rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth, beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Charity never faileth. But whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part shall be done away. When I was a child, I spake as a child, I understood as a child, I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. And now we see through a glass, darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know, even as also I am known. And now abideth faith, hope, love, these three, but the greatest of these is love. From 1 John. And we have known and believed the love that God hath to us. God is love, and he that dwelleth in love, dwelleth in God, and God in him. Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out fear. Because fear hath torment, he that feareth is not made perfect in love. We love him, because he first loved us.
Amen. Thank you, man. Let me ask that as we continue the ceremony, that you turn off your cell phones if you haven't already. Also, that no pictures be taken during the ceremony, and we would appreciate that so much. I've asked you to work on your vows and select vows that express your heart's desire. Because God takes vows very seriously. And the vows that you speak to one another are more than words spoken to each other. You're making vows to God today. And God really takes our vows seriously. If you would, join hands now. And I'll ask that you repeat after me. Riley, we'll begin with you. If you would repeat after me, I take you, Amanda.
I take you, Amanda.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
That we may become one in spirit.
And we may become one in spirit.
One in mind.
One in mind.
One in affection.
One in affection.
And above all things.
And above all things.
One in Christ.
One in Christ.
Amanda, would you also repeat after me? I take you, Riley.
I take you, Riley.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
That we may become one in spirit.
That we may become one in spirit.
One in mind.
One in mind.
One in affection.
One in affection.
And above all things.
And above all things.
One in Christ.
One in Christ.
The wedding rings that you will be sharing now are a beautiful outward and visible symbol of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two loyal hearts in endless love. Riley, if you'll take these rings. The ring is a beautiful circle reminding us of the love that you have for one another, that it doesn't end. The ring also is made of beautiful metal, purest white gold, symbolizing the purity of your love for each other. The purity that we have in Christ, for we have no purity outside of Him, but in Him He has cleansed us from all sin and made us pure. If you would, place the rings upon Amanda's finger, and as you do, repeat after me. This ring I give you,
this ring I give you,
in token and pledge,
in token and pledge,
of my constant faith.
Faith.
I will love you.
I will love you.
I will cherish you.
I will cherish you.
I will not forsake you.
I will not forsake you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amanda, as you place this ring upon Riley's finger, would you also repeat after me? This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
In token and pledge.
Of my constant faith.
I will love you.
I will love you.
I will cherish you.
I will cherish you.
I will not forsake you.
I will not forsake you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. We're going to have the unity candle now. And in a moment I'll ask that family representative from each family come and light the candle representing their family. And after they have done that, then the two of you will take the candles representing your families and light the unity candle, igniting the other candles, extinguishing the other candles. We do this to symbolize what is taking place here. You to leave your parents and become one. The scripture says that Adam was to leave and not have any connection with anyone but his wife. And it was a symbol of our coming together and cleaving to our wives. So that you hold on to each other and you no longer have to be obedient to your parents. Now, Scripture teaches us that we're to honor our parents, so I advise you to seek counsel, wise counsel, from your parents. But you have to determine before God what you should do. So cleave, hold on tight to each other. Cleave means to hold on as if you're falling off a cliff and you grab a branch or tree limb and you hold on to it for dear life. That's how you're to hold on to each other throughout your married life. If the representatives for each family would come now and light the candle representing your family. Read to you from Philippians chapter 4, verses 4 through 9. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again I say, rejoice. Let your reasonableness be known to everyone. The Lord is at hand. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is holy, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, practice these things. And the God of peace will be with you. That's also our prayer for you. That God's peace will flow through you and throughout your marriage. Your marriage will be a blessing to all who know you. This concludes our service. You've taken your vows. You've made them unto one another and unto God. Therefore, by the laws of the state of Texas and by divine authority, I pronounce you Riley and Amanda lawfully wed, husband and wife. From the beginning, God made man and woman to be joined together permanently in marriage. Therefore, a man is to leave his father and his mother, and he and his wife are to be united so that they are no longer two, but become one. And no man can separate what God has joined together. You may kiss your wife. Thank you. fellowship hall for the reception if you like, or you can wait in here while they take pictures. I would ask that you not greet them until they finish taking all the pictures so that we can get through this.
Oh man, I asked my Okay, I'm Amber, the maid of honor, and I have known Amanda for about 5 years. And I don't really know what else to say.
Have you ever used this
pretty
before?
Much said it all, but no. I'm glad that
but
I
know you could do it.
Go on a date with Riley.
Let's be done with that. Let me show you some other
games.
Okay. Let's show you.
You
don't get real cool.
No.
What?
Okay.
Now don't do pumpkin. Okay. What do you want to do?
We've had plenty of fun times.
Christopher.
And
Christopher.
Oh, I am me. Yeah.
Thank you, Amber. Would anyone else like to say anything? Dad.
Yeah. Would you like to say something? A toast? Would you like to make a toast?
This is your name. This is your name.
New game.
Do you want to see?
Heroic? Normal? Or what?
Hey, Christopher, quiet down.
You know what? I just forgot what I was going to say. I had it all planned out. It was so cool.
I just tried to flee
the guy. It was hilarious.
Christopher, come here.
I don't know what happened.
Come here.
Sorry.
Walk around here. Come here.
Congratulations, anyway. I hope you have a funny, funny life.
Okay, I think we're going to have a few more events. That would be like the first dance, and yes, then you can change. That's fine. Yeah, you promised me the first dance, so we have to do that, and then you can change.
Let's get it on! Do you want to operate the camera?
No.
All you have to do is hold it.
No.
Okay. They're going to do the first dance. So you're going to stay here and wait for me and watch it. Want a sip of beer?
Oh,
go ahead.
This is that's a good kind of beer.
Mm-hmm. It's Dos Equis.
That is some good beer, man. What? I like some kind of beer.
Everything that you inside and out.
to do?
Wait.
Just sit here.
Now we'll have the father walk ahead.
Okay.
You have to cut off the grass?
No, you have to plant plants that kill zombies.
What?
Show them, Christopher.
Cut off the grass and then you're seeing. Now, see that sun? And you see any falling sun? Something on it. Tap on it. Keep on collecting. Whenever that thing is up, click on it and then click where on the ground it wants.
Get your house.
How do I do it?
Do they?
They automatically do.
Just try to get
that
song.
Can I do it?
When
it's white.
Tell the videographer.
Now you can place it anywhere on the grass.
Oh, somebody beat you to it.
It's okay.
Some zombies like crazy. Final way of zombies.
Isn't that final way?
I agree with that.
End of the game. I'm hitting. Alright, you got almost another one. Let's play something else. This thing creates sun. Is that cool? Now, zombies are coming forward. Sunflower makes sun. They're an extremely important plant. Try to plant at least 3 of them. But this is fun. And when you're done.
Alright! Perfect! Christopher, don't
I'm
grab
sorry,
like
he's,
that.
He's gonna die. Now, get the pea shooter.
So, I just got word that now we can party.
Woohoo!
So, we're gonna go ahead and crank it up.
I don't want zombies to get past.
Chicken fried, cold beer on